G'day and welcome to Ranneko and Syfro Play Pit People by Behemoth Games. Hey, I'm Ranneko.
And I'm Syfro.
Smooth. Totally organic.
Very,
excellent.
Very smooth. Yes. All right. This is very professional. It's a very professional business we're running here.
Yeah.
Pit People, I saw a couple of other people playing around the internet and it looked freaking awesome. Like, ridiculous awesome. Behemoth Games, these guys are like Castle Crashers and other stuff like that, which is kind of, it's like Rule of Cool, but more Rule of Dumb.
Yes, it is very dumb, but it's pretty fun. And
absolutely.
I have watched a brief intro video on the game. I think the trailer for the game. And that's it. Mm-hmm. So I'm relying on Syfro giving me good advice.
Oh, well, I was purposely not looking too deep into the game, so I could be pleasantly surprised.
I was meaning good advice as to the quality of the game.
Well, hopefully I'm on the mark with this one. Anyway, it's an early access, but the new update has come online, so that should give us a lot to work with here.
Yep, it promises turn-based co-op.
Yes, which is awesome.
I have a worry here. So there is one player is a single mouse button, and two player is an A button press. Is this local co-op at this stage only?
No. I've certainly seen it being played online.
So let's just check options. Online settings. I do see an online settings.
Online settings. Text chat, voice chat.
I'm just going to turn off push to talk at this time.
Yeah, let's just get rid of that. We don't need that. We have our own methods. Always allow a comic. Yeah, that's all fine.
All right, so I guess this is just local player.
Certainly has online component.
Okay.
All right, let's get in. I think we have to play for a little bit before we can actually connect to each other, but...
Okay, well, let's give it a go.
That should be fine. Press button.
Yep.
This one.
My god, it's full of stars.
It's cool that it was local co-op as well. That's actually a feature I really like.
Yeah, definitely.
Whoa. This game is actually loud. Like, super loud.
I'm really glad that my audio is on different tracks.
Mm-hmm.
I can't imagine a world without the bear or the storms. Yes, the storms. Beautiful waves of emerald blood cry down from the heavens, promising death in lawless disarray, constantly upsetting the order. I get butterflies in my tummy just thinking about it.
Yes. Delightful.
Yes.
Mm.
Speaking of which,
what's with giant bears floating through space, though?
Let's see. Oh, it's Horatio.
They're unbearable. No, I'm sorry, that was low-hanging fruit right there. Okay, I'm actually going to go ahead and turn you up a bit because this is really, really quiet.
That's fair enough. I thought I checked options. I hope there's a subtitles option.
Well, voice in the sky seems to be a bit of a jerk.
Just a bit.
Alright, hold on. Okay. I'm just going to turn you up.
Okay.
Because
you could turn the game down as well.
I could turn the game down.
And I'm also just going to see subtitles are, of course, in gameplay settings. I'm also going to turn on shoot damage flags, because why the hell wouldn't I want to see how much damage someone has taken? And it's a turn-based adventure.
That's true.
It's good.
Okay. Say some words.
More words.
Awesome. Let's get a little bit more of that Ranneko in there. There we go. Okay, cool. That should be fine. Jerkimedes appears to be appropriately named.
Right. It looks like you declare all your actions, and then you kind of press the end turn button, and it plays them out.
Mm-hmm.
Which I guess makes sense if you're building for a co-op base.
Exactly. Yeah, what's cool about this is, eat the child, come on.
I hear they're delicious.
Oh, one of my guys is down already. Well, this sucks. Let's go, Horatio. Let's do this. Just tell Horatio where to go. Yeah, what I like about this is that it's kind of simplified turn-based strategy, right? In that all you do is tell the guys where to go, and they will... They'll take it from there, right?
Right.
Shield is great for blocking arrows. Awesome. And what that basically means is that each of your turns go by really quickly. Like, you're not waiting on animation, you're not waiting on a queuing everyone to attack.
Yeah, that's definitely a big problem in, that can happen in turn-based games. It can just take forever to get anything done.
Yes. Looks like Horatio just took a lot of arrows, but he's fine.
Yeah.
Go, Horatio. Oh, wow. Horatio's a badass.
Mm-hmm.
So these giant storm globs of goop appears to be fine?
Yeah.
Like, they're hitting the battlefield, but I'm not getting touched. Okay.
I'm not entirely clear on how the arrows work, either.
Like, the arrows that are attacking you?
Yeah, is it that they each were doing 2 damage? Because that doesn't seem to add up.
No, I think they are... Oh, okay. I guess the storm did do something. Oh.
Yeah, I'm slightly ahead of you.
Yeah.
So I'm trying not to let you know these things.
Uh-huh.
Mmm, delicious child.
Well, Space Bear's a jerk. Yeah, okay. When it looks like whenever you get the coin above you, it's blocked to attack successfully.
Ah.
So... Oh, Jerkmeez is gone.
What a jerkbag.
Alright, let's get him. Finish him off. His name was Child Eater. Awesome. Well, he's dead now. Alas, Horatio.
Okay, so the next part... The map movement is not based on... turns. The map movement is just click and he moves towards the mouse cursor. Okay.
Ooh.
Let's see if this actually will take me to a point where we can play together.
Well, the narrator is being kind of obnoxious and talking over you.
That's what editing's for.
That is what editing's for. If only I had... Oh, dear. If only I had separate tracks. Okie dokie. So, this, I guess, is the overworld map where you can walk over the world. And for now, we're just covered in goop, it looks like. Oh dear, that's all the goop. Oh dear, that man got gooped.
Yep, it seems to be an epidemic.
Or a pandemic.
Alright, I'm going to wait for you to catch up.
Uh-huh.
I'm currently seeing a line that says, "You're too late, princess."
Princess? Well, this took a twist. And also, I got hit by a glob just now, but that didn't seem to do much.
I don't think it is a scripted glob, so you're fine.
So, now that there's a storm of green, etc., everyone's just kind of being jerks to each other. Alright, I've got Helmitor, he's saying, "Too late, princess."
Excellent, let's keep going then.
Now we're in sync.
Stay away from my father!
Where's her father? I don't see her father anywhere.
On the left?
Oh, so he is. Wow, that's a lot of arrows.
Like how she's ready to punch them all.
Mm-hmm, obviously. Punch them out.
King Papastrika, or whatever.
Yeah, well, I was looking forward to punching things, but this'll do too. I like these cutscenes. They're pretty cute.
Mallets get bonus damage against helmets.
Swords are weak against helmets. Okay, so helmets are specifically... Alright, cool. That's good to know. Oh, and it even gives you a little thumbs up for when you're attacking the right target. That's cool. You go here. You can't cross the goop, so just go here and tank all you can. Get him, Horatio! Yeah, okay. That's pretty good feedback.
I wonder how much health the heroes have. I mean, that's the other question I have, right?
How much health they have?
Yeah, I think I'll just have them stay put, and then they can beat up everyone. Sensible.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I think that's a good play right now. Horatio appears to be like tanky because he got a shield.
He's got a big shield.
She's got a... Can they swap places?
I wonder. Maybe. Let's find out.
I don't think I want to. Because right now, Horatio's tanking for three of them, and I want to keep him tanking three of them.
Yeah, see, I've got the opposite one right now.
Mmm. But yeah.
I think it's hard for them to swap. Oh, no. It definitely worked. Eventually.
Right. It seems like the units will attack whoever they can, right?
Yeah.
So all these archers are just attacking whoever's in their range. And apparently also some empty squares because they're bad at their jobs. Oh, and they're actually hitting their friends as well. That's interesting.
Whoops, I moved Horatio. That was a mistake. Oh well.
Eh. You lost Horatio. Okay, just keep going. Yeah, just keep beating this guy up, man. If these guys could stop shooting arrows at me, that'd be great.
It really would.
Although it appears that they're just kind of hitting this giant area.
Yeah, I think arrows are like a scatter attack, which is interesting.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, so I've finished the guys off on the left.
I assume I can save the king. Okay, here we go. Helmetites. Okay.
Chaotic job, gentlemen. Go wreak havoc elsewhere. Sorry, Pip. Are you upset?
This game is entirely ridiculous.
It is, just a tad.
Kingy! Aww.
I don't think it ended well for him.
He could be okay.
Well, we got a nice big club.
Have you seen X-Men Apocalypse?
Helms Forever. No.
Well, don't, because it's terrible, but... I mean, someone survived something like that. Aww, she's serious now.
Okay, that's that first mission done.
Easy game. Okay, and now we... Outlook and reckless bravery captivated Horatio. So much, in fact, that he immediately forgot about his son and his home and... Yes, you did. I see. Horatio gave Pipistrella the remainder of his blueberries, and they headed for the city. The perfect place to recuperate and make plans for Horatio's inevitable failure and death. Plus, there's a pretty good restaurant there that has great beef stew and cornbread.
The narrator's a bit of a jerk. More than a bit, really.
Hmm?
You'll see.
Okay. Keep moving.
I really hope that at the city we can actually, you know...
Yes, actually start co-oping. That would be great.
Maybe looking into this would have been helpful.
I will keep all my blueberries. Oh. Blueberries are even the icon. Nice. Okay, starting new. I find a pitcher, get some gold. Let's try find another guy to help us out. Sure. Can I? Okay, literally everything else is locked. Yeah, here we go. Here's the telephone. The telephone gets us.
Where's the telephone? Demi-cyclops. Okay, that's someone with two eyes, I guess.
Unfair co-op versus people.
Let's join souls. Sure.
Unfair co-op. I like the voices. I like the voices a lot. Sure. Bring it. Wait. What does joining souls actually mean?
It appears to
mean something other than what I thought.
I do not know what is going on. It is very strange.
Whoa. We're mitosising. Oh, and now there's... Oh, jeez. Oh, there's a happy bear and sad bear. And now we're magical girls.
Yeah, but now I'm in a fight. Whoa, what just happened?
This is perplexing. Thumbs up! Yeah! something just happened.
So there's at least one more fight.
What did just happen? I wonder if there's some kind of lore involved there, because the characters seem to know as little as I do. Mm-hmm. Damn straight, Horatio. You got a big shield. Let's do this. Alright, Pip, you go up here. I think this guy... Okay. Okay, so guys he can attack are highlighted in blue.
Yeah, but I don't know how to tell which one they will attack.
Oh, it's random. They attack who they want to.
Righto.
So, the only way you can really force them to attack one person is to put them in a position where they can only attack one person.
That seems kind of reasonable, I guess.
Man, this guy's got an alligator hat. Check him out. Throwing axe has a chance to stun your enemy. Haha. To throw, leave hex. Makes sense. I like this formation. Go.
Bring forth the speckled horseman.
This sword appears to be most ineffective. I wonder if swords are better anyway.
The speckled horseman, he has guns. He's not on a horse. There are so many things wrong with this picture.
Well, he came in on a giraffe. Well, the giraffe was at least a little speckled. That kind of counts. Okay, Horatio, you move over here. Because you can't hit helmet guy anyway. There you go, that's tactics. Yep, you can axe stun, not a problem. You, go here. Oh, this guy kind of moved up in my face, didn't he? You here. Yes. Tactics. Focus fire would have been nice, but whatever, I'll allow it. Ah, evaded. Oh, geez. Okay, so I'm getting hit by a lot of stuff, but I'm not actually taking that much damage, it looks like.
Ooh, I got triple kill.
Which is fine by me. Hit him. Hit him again. Yeah, I do like how quickly the turns go by.
Yeah, that works out fairly well. I don't know how to stun with my axe. That was mentioned as a thing that can be done.
Yes, it's when you throw the axes, they have a chance to stun. It's not something you actively control. Right.
So yeah, there is no active ability, which is kind of what you said previously, so that gels. Horatio MVPP!
Keep going. I'm in a good position. Keep going. Double kill. Here we go. Not quite on par with your triple kill, but I'll allow it.
Now, you really should listen to me, Horatio.
Yeah, you and you go here. Yes, go, buddies.
Oh, also, you get loot for having played Castle Crashers, apparently.
Oh. Well, I've played Castle Crashers.
Yeah, but it says you fight well. He gives you a house. Take one by the market. Have you played Castle Crashers on your computer?
Maybe. Maybe not on this computer.
Okay, let's see. Can we now actually play online? Yes, two-player setup area. Player two-team setup area. No, that's like, not co-op. That's the opposite of co-op.
I choose my hero. A hero is stronger, has more health. Who did you pick as your hero?
I think I picked Horatio.
Alright, I'll pick the princess. Hey, I have played Castle Crashers. Hey, I got knights. Awesome. And a green knight. Yay, I got a house. Do I get a phone? Oh, come on. Give me that. Yeah, okay.
Okay, then you got to venture out and battle for something.
Play to set up area. That's fine.
Could not find a way to talk to you. Oh, wow. There's the giant bear. This actually, the giant bear reminds me of a role-playing game. Have you ever heard of The Day After Ragnarok?
No, I thought you were going to go after Sir Barrington with that one, but...
No.
You went somewhere else.
So The Day After Ragnarok is the Nazis summon the world-eating snake at the end of World War II. And then the Allies barely kill it by nuking it in the eye.
Okay, that makes sense.
And that kind of leaves a giant dead snake wrapping the world.
That will cause problems.
It does. It crushed Germany.
Oh. Well, that was a poor move on Hitler's part.
And there's a literal snake forming a divide between East and West.
Yeah, I can
see
that.
Also took out the UK. And apparently the poison takes out the US. So it's a...
Oh,
it's a, like,
that's too bad.
The US part of the setting is kind of swords and sorcery almost.
I see, because... Well,
because
giant snakes.
Giant snake poison.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. I remember...
You're blowing this thing.
Oh, what system was it? I think it's Doomtown. Dead Town, Doomtown, Doomtown. It's like a Western RPG. Oh, he punched her into the back of his car. All right, let's get him. He can't do that.
We're doing the exact same fight.
Get out of here.
Again.
Let's get him. But yeah, in that the spellcasting works really interestingly... In that whenever you want to cast a spell, you play poker against the DM.
Oh, right, yeah.
Yeah. One at a time. Foes have mind of your own. Tell them where to go, but not who to attack. Of course.
I mean, didn't we already know that?
Well, it didn't tell us explicitly.
Yeah, but...
All right, I mean, so I'll set Horatio into blocking formation and then send the princess...
The princess is clearly a flanker.
To flank, yes, clearly. That guy's got a fishbone bow. Uh-oh, trouble down here. They're throwing bones at me. This is not something I agreed to. Alright, what's her name? Pipistrella, that's her name. Okay. You go here, everyone else is fine.
Me, Donnie, say you cat screws and bruising.
I assume he's stunned. He's still dizzy, moving around just fine. Oh!
Me, Donnie, where's
that? That guy sent me flying. You're fine. You're fine. Wait, no, you're not fine. You move over here. You go. Oh, wow, you're really slow. That's fine. Cruising for a bruising. Good to see the writing in this game is like really top notch.
Hey, how come I can see how close I am to death? The giant souls remember cyclop powers, dude. No time to explain.
Oh, almost made a mistake. I do like how that is actually cool, how it gives you a moment to reconsider ending your turn.
Yeah.
It's kind of like a would you like to end your turn, but better. I don't know, I like it better. It goes a bit faster. Okay. Here's good, and yep, that's all good. Hopefully Pip doesn't... Hey, I leveled up. Hopefully Pip does all right down there. She attacked the wrong target, but that's fine.
I'm really hoping Pip doesn't die.
Yeah, my Pip is totally going down.
And she just died.
Okay, maybe she should just go up here and focus on him. Go for it. And they can just run after
level
me if they
up.
Really want to fight. I don't know what stunning actually does.
And leveling heals you as well.
Oh, that's good. Oh, no. Oh, Pip's in a bad place. And now if this
well,
guy...
I mean, she's in a better place than my Pip.
Is your Pip already dead?
Yeah.
Ah, I see. Alright, well, I'm going to send Pip over there. I'm going to send Horatio to block them off. And then... All right, you get in there. Hopefully they won't go after Pip. Damn it, they're going after Pip. Well, one of them's not. Oh, geez. Come on, Pip. You gotta want it. Pip's in serious trouble right now.
Well,
okay.
Things happen like that. How is Judy the Chug not dead yet? Damn it.
Yes! Pip might be alive. Pip might stay alive if this guy doesn't go after. And he's not. Awesome. But the archer might kill her. Damn it, the archer killed her. Oh, that's not good. Well, at least Horatio's doing well.
Yeah, Horatio's kicking ass.
And I made Pip the hero as well. The new world. Recruitador Sophia.
Finally the new world. I recruitador Sophia to claim this land for Spain. Natives, buenavidos, will you be my guide?
Why not?
Sure.
Hey, Yosef was MVP.
Horatio was MVP for me.
Yeah, my Yosef kept the big guy kind of stunned for a couple of turns, so I think that gives him a decent mana bonus.
Quest complete, so now we get to go back.
Yes!
Please let us get to talk to people.
Uh-huh. Oh, it's a
cupcake. There's a thing in the way. Woo, I bet we won't have to fight that.
Cutscene.
Yeah.
I actually really like these cutscenes.
Security checkpoint.
That appears to be the least effective prison ever. I don't think that's how you eat a cupcake. He shot the camera.
Pretty sure this is how we kill all of them. Alright, jumps, time to hand me a gold.
Mm-hmm. Place items here and scram. Ah, I see this is not exactly a security force. The voice on gluten is amazing.
Uh-huh. Kill everyone except your recruit, then throw a net at your recruit and take the fighter home. Okay.
That's one way to make friends.
And influence people.
Yes.
Good job shooting your own guy in the back, dumbass.
What? Yosef is bleeding and almost dead. This is a problem.
I guess he didn't level?
I guess not. You go here, Sophia. Horatio, dive deep. Hey. It doesn't actually tell you what leveling does.
It heals you. I assume it makes you better in other ways. But instant heal is pretty nice too.
Yes, that is always a plus. Oh. Horatio, I want you to get closer to these guys.
Oh, come on, they're nearly dead. Frontliners.
Yay.
Just kill them all.
Yosef is now healed. He's a happy guy.
Yosef just leveled.
Yep. Yosef's good at this game, man.
So your princess did not die in the last one.
She did, actually. But she appears to be fine.
Yeah, same. I just wanted to check to see if we were all scrubs or just me.
No, we are all scrubs. Okay, so the cupcake, so gluten I should call him, appears to throw bits of himself to people to heal them. And he loses health when he does this.
I see.
Oh, and he missed. Now there's a pile of...
Keep healing or you wish had never been baked? Nice.
Go, buddies. Oh, awesome. It'll say if an enemy cupcake leaves goo on the floor, you can, like, walk over it to eat it. Cut him off. Cut him off at the pass. Go, buddies. Can I make Sophia a hero? Because this music is awesome.
Okay, Bandit Gang defeated.
I'm free!
Recruited Gluten the Cupcake. Now I've got a healer!
How do I... Hold on, how do I make her recruit him?
It's just an attack that she can take as long as you're in one of the slots around it within two squares.
I see. Did it!
They regenerate their health when low, they're weak to poison.
Mm-hmm.
Oh wow, look at the image for the cupcake when you get that.
Oh wow. Oh, that's handsome.
Mm-hmm.
That is very, very handsome. Oh, they regenerate when low. That's cool.
Yeah, so, I mean, there's a reason to keep doing it.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, I mean, like, ultimately, your orgasm more valuable than a cupcake.
Unlocked insane mode. That's fine. I don't care about that. Oh, wait. Yes, space phone! Yes, we can play online at long last. But maybe we should make that episode 2.
Whoa. I got a bunch of... Oh, I got an olive on a toothpick.
Mm-hmm. So once you've done that, I suggest we stop and we start number 2. Because otherwise this is a super long episode.
Yes.
Let me know when you are ready with the space phone.
Insane difficulty on and off. Space phone. Yes. Okay. Well, this game is suitably ridiculous.
Yep.
Are you interested in insane difficulty at all?
I think we should play a bit on normal difficulty before moving up to insane.
That sounds like Trump talk but to me.
I guess we will see you guys next time when we actually play this co-op game we bought to play co-op together.
Yes, and then we shall co-op in the coop.
Indeed.
See you guys then.
Until then, bye. Thanks for watching. I really appreciate you spending the time and effort watching the videos I make. If you'd like to watch more, on the left there should be another video from this playlist, on the right there will be whatever YouTube recommends, and in the center there is a convenient subscribe button just in case you need it.